Good morning, students. Today we will start a new chapter, Cell, Structural and Functional Unit of Life. First of all, we must be knowing why cell is called the structural and functional unit of life. Let's justify it one by one. First, it is called structural unit because we know all living organism, either they are plants, animals, microorganism, all are made up of cells. So cell is the structural unit of life. Now, second one for justification is why it is called the functional unit of life. It is called functional unit because all the basic functions required for our survival is performed by the cell at its basic level. So cell is the basic function, basic unit or fundamental unit of our life. So as a whole, we can say cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Now if you see how it was discovered, so there is a first introduction, that is discovery of the cell. Robert Hooke in 1665 discovered cell and he observed the slice of the cork. He took a thin slice of the bark of oak tree and he took this thin slice and observed under the microscope. Actually speaking, the microscope was self-made microscope, or not so advanced or refined. It was a kind of crude microscope. He was able to see empty box-like structures or the compartment, and he called them honeycomb-like structures. Why he was not able to see nucleus or cytoplasm, which are present in cell? As we know by now that cell is having the living components like nucleus and cytoplasm, that time Robert Hooke was not able to see, or he was not able to observe nucleus and nucleus and cytoplasm. The reason is the cell he took for observation under his self-made microscope, those cells were dead because bark of the tree is considered to be the dead cell. Now the first living cell was discovered by A.V. Leeuwenhoek, which is not mentioned here in NCERT, but it was discovered by A.V. Leeuwenhoek under his improved microscope. The microscope with the high magnification, high enlargement, so the living cell was discovered much later after the discovery of the dead cell. So as a whole, Robert Hooke discovered cell in 1665, and later on A.V. Leeuwenhoek, that is Anton von Leeuwenhoek, discovered the living cell under his advanced microscope. Now this one we have already discussed why it is called the basic structural unit. The way any building is made up of cell, brick, same way our body or living organism's body is made up of cell. If you see in case of this, you will understand why it is called structural unit with the help of this analogy, where brick wall is shown, and the wall is shown here to be made up of brick, and brick is the smallest unit. Same way you can see this tissue of onion peel, and you can see that cells are closely held together and all the cells combine together to form tissue. It means the basic unit of onion peel is cell only. So either plant or animal or microorganism, everyone's body is made up of cell. That's why cell is the structural unit of life. Not only structural, it is the functional unit also, because whatever functions are required for our survival, may it be nutrition, respiration, excretion, everything is performed by the cell at the basic level. Now this one also we have discussed, like organisms can be divided into different categories on the basis of number of cell they have. For example, if you see there are two type of organism, that is, one is unicellular organism and multicellular organism. Unicellular organism are those organisms whose body is made up of single cell, like amoeba, paramecium and multicellular organism are those organism whose body is made up of many cells. As you can see here, multi means many, cellular means cell. So the way like if you see in your case or animal's body, their body is made up of many cells. And in case of unicellular organism, the body is made up of single cell like amoeba and paramecium. And even Euglena, some bacteria, they all are unicellular organism. In case of unicellular organism, single cell perform all the basic functions. But in case of multicellular organism, because many cells are there and cells, they combine to form tissue, combine to form organ system, and as a whole we have got a higher level of organization. But in case of unicellular, single cell perform all the function, and in case of multicellular organism, there is a division of work or division of labor which is possible. Thank you very much. Revise the chapter.